Microsoft Dynamics 365 Business Central. Working with inventory costing. When creating a new item in Microsoft Dynamics 365 Business Central, one of the important things to specify is the costing method. The costing method defines how the item is valued when it enters our inventory, while we store it, and when it leaves inventory. We can choose from five costing methods: FIFO, LIFO, average, specific, and standard. For FIFO and LIFO costing, when an item is sold, the value process is the actual value of either the first or last receipt of the item. The average costing method calculates the average cost of an item with every positive adjustment. With the specific costing method, the item is valued with the exact cost of that item's receipt. Lastly, the standard costing method will use a preset unit cost, and when the actual cost is realized, the standard cost will be adjusted to the actual through variances. When you purchase goods, the goods are received through a purchase order or purchase invoice. Receipt of goods can also have additional costing elements like freight, insurance, and duty. Before posting these additional purchase invoices, you will need to assign the value to the specific purchase receipts so that the additional cost is passed to the items. To create a purchase invoice for costing, choose the search icon at the top right of the screen, type Purchase Invoices, and choose the Purchase Invoices link in the search results. Now we'll choose New to create a new purchase invoice and then fill in the information required on the purchase header. On the purchase line, we'll choose the Type Charge item and choose the Freight Charge in the Number field. We'll set the quantity to 1 and then set the direct unit cost with the amount for the freight. The next step is to assign this cost to a specific purchase receipt. We'll press Line, Related Information, and then the Item Charge Assignment option. The Item Charge Assignment page will open, and we'll press Item Charge and then Get Receipt Lines to select the receipt lines we want to assign the cost to. Now we'll select the lines and press OK to transfer them to the Item Charge Assignment page. To get some help to assign the cost correctly, we'll choose Item Charge and then Suggest Item Charge Assignment. In the message box that appears, we'll need to choose how we'll distribute costs to the receipt lines. Equally, we'll divide the amount equally per line. The other three options will assign the amount based on the amount, the weight, or the volume of each line. We'll choose OK to continue. The quantity to assign is now filled in for each line. We'll choose Closed, and then post the purchase invoice. Posting will create additional value entries for each item ledger entry of the item's receipts, increasing the cost of each item by the amount assigned. And that's it. Thanks for watching.